Hello guys, welcome to Inspiring Minds. This is Dr. Sonal. Today we are going to discuss one of the most important topics of anatomy, which is brachial plexus. Every year you get one or two questions from this topic. You might get an image-based question or direct one-liner from this topic. So, let's get started. Brachial plexus is a network of nerve fibers which supplies the skin and muscles of the upper limb. Now, let's see the anatomical codes. The brachial plexus begins in the root of neck. It passes between scalene medius and scalene anterior muscle. Then it reaches the axilla and then passes through the upper limb. Let's see the origin now. The brachial plexus is formed by the anterior rami of C5, C6, C7, C8 and T1 spinal nerves. The C5 and C6 nerve root, they combine to form the upper trunk. C7 directly gives the middle trunk, and C8 and T1, they combine to form the lower trunk. Now each trunk, it gives two division, anterior and posterior division. The anterior division of upper and middle trunk, they combine to form the lateral cord. The posterior division of all three trunks, they combine to form the posterior cord. And the anterior division of lower trunk, it gives the medial cord. Now, these three cords, they further give major branches. So, let's see the lateral cord. It gives two major branches, musculocutaneous nerve and lateral root of median nerve. Now, the posterior cord gives axillary nerve, radial and radial nerve. And the medial cord, it gives medial root of the median nerve and ulnar nerve. Now, we get minor branches as well from the brachial plexus. The first two minor branches which we get are from roots. The first one is the dorsal scapular nerve and the long thoracic nerve. Then the other two are from the upper trunk. And these are suprascapular nerve and subclavius nerve. Now, the divisions, they don't give any further branch. The branches which we get from the lateral cord are lateral pectoral nerve. We just get one branch from the lateral cord and three minor branches from the posterior cord, upper and lower scapular nerve and thoracodorsal nerve. Now, three branches from the medial cord, medial pectoral nerve, medial cutaneous nerve of arm and medial cutaneous nerve of forearm. Now, if we see in total, we get 11 minor branches from the two from the roots, two from the trunk, and seven from the cords, and five major branches from the cords directly. Now, let's see the branches from the roots. So, we get dorsal scapular nerve and long thoracic nerve. Dorsal scapular nerve, it supplies the levator scapulae, rhomboides minor and rhomboides major. Now, these are the muscles, as you can see in this picture. This is the dorsal scapular nerve, which supplies the levator scapulae, rhomboides minor and rhomboides major. And this one is the long thoracic nerve supplying the serratus anterior muscle. Now, let's see the branches from the upper trunk. We get suprascapular nerve. It supplies the supraspinatus and infraspinatus muscle. The supraspinatus muscle is responsible for the abduction of shoulder up to 15 degrees. And we get other branch, that is nerve to subclavius. It supplies the subclavian muscle. Now let's see the branches from the cords. The lateral cord, as you can see, gives musculocutaneous nerve, lateral root of the median nerve, lateral pectoral nerve. So we get three branches from the lateral cord, two major branches and one minor branches. So the mnemonic for the lateral cord goes like LML, LML. Okay, so this is the lateral root of median nerve, musculocutaneous nerve and lateral pectoral nerve. The lateral pectoral nerve, it supplies the pectoralis major muscle. Then it pierces the clavipectoral fascia and forms the Lateral cutane is now of forearm. Now, let's see the branches of the posterior cord. From posterior cord, we get axillary nerve, we get axillary nerve and radial nerve. And three minor branches, that is upper scapular nerve, lower scapular nerve and thoracodorsal nerve. Thoracodorsal nerve is also known as nerve to latissimus dorsi. So we get three minor nerve branches and two major nerves. From the medial cord, we get ulnar nerve, medial pectoral nerve, medial cutaneous nerve of forearm and arm, and medial root of median nerve. So we get two major branches again from the medial cord and three minor branches. Now let's see the root values of the cords, and these values are very important from the MCQ point of view. You have to by heart the values. Now the lateral cord, the root value goes like C5, C6, C7. For posterior cord, it is C5, C6, C7, C8 and T1. For medial cord, it is C8 and T1.